And now it's my pleasure to actually extend a little bit Dr. Krintas, Theodore Krintas, keynote. He'll quickly do a 10-minute keynote, which is a nice way to sum what you guys have just heard here. And the keynote goes as the fundamental sailing trip in the crypto sea. Over right. To you.
Thank you. So let me start saying that when I was 16, I wanted to become a musician. So I really much loved all those sitting at the back. So I'd like to thank you for sitting at the back. It reminds me of my young age. So the idea for this speech was to make a little bit of understanding how fundamentals could help us in this crypto sea that we are running. And basically, fundamentals have three points that we touch. First of all, the economy. Never forget that the economy is us. There's nothing else. It's only us. So the economy is important to understand at which stage the economy starts, where it ends. Then the sector. And finally, the financials, the specific data, the specific financials of the asset. What we try to understand is the expectations valuation. Right. Thank you. So when we talk about fundamentals, we have these five different points, let's say, from the business concept, what it makes sense in our area, to the management. In our case here, when we say management, because cryptos are not a company, so we refer to network, to the competition, and don't forget that the fiat competition will be hard. Governments and banks like very much to own what currencies can offer, so they will compete. The final financial analysis, and as I said a couple of times already, demand and supply. Now, going to demand and supply, and which is the basic economic force, let me tell you that in order to have an equilibrium, we need at least, at any given point in time, demand to equal supply and vice versa. So on demand side, when we have a bull market, demands increases. Neutrality, which is the key concept for Bitcoin and the cryptocurrency space, is very important, as well as the total money supply. A couple of speakers earlier talked about governments increasing the money supply, in other words, printing their currency several ways whenever they feel they need to do so, and as a result they increase the supply. That increased supply takes one way or another the currency out of the question through inflation or through lowering the price. Now on the supply side, supply increases when markets are bear, supply increases when block rewards are higher and when block time is lower. So in other words, talking about the sector, we have at least three important elements that we should focus to: the network and the state that the network is right now. It is very important because we shouldn't forget the whole discussion we're having this today and tomorrow is about a network. Then the algorithm. Bitcoin is based on a specific algorithm, which the state of the algorithm is very important for all of us to feel confident about the currency itself. And finally, the difficulty to get new bitcoins into the market. So here is a chart. This is a logarithmic scale chart. What you see with the red dots is whenever the difficulty level gets negative. In other words, when it gets easier to have bitcoins, the result is a new bull market. And it's simple. Now here is another chart. What you see is Bitcoin Cash in price, the orange line. And in blue line, we have the total funding to Bitcoin startups. So as new startups are getting funded, in other words, as we increase supply, then the currency price goes down. Demand and supply, either we like it or not, economic 101 works everywhere. Now the financials. In order to understand the value on any asset, we have three elements to focus to. First of all, competition. Who are we competing with? What is the important or the serious basics in the market? How can we overcome the fact that they are already in the market and they have already a lot of funds in the market? Then the utility. And the utility, it's nice that we're sitting here in Limassol in Cyprus. The utility of Bitcoin for most of us is not as high as it is for an African guy living in Zimbabwe or in Kenya. Most of us are not excluded from the banking sector. Most of them are completely excluded. We have credit cards, debit cards. We have all the means to pursue a transaction, instant transactions. They don't. So to give you an idea, utility is a function that is very important in Bitcoin for approximately 4 billion people on this earth. And this is what it's all about. And finally, history. As I said just a few minutes ago, when we don't have history, we have to have patience. And it is my belief that we need to be patient with this crypto space, and we see very interesting things to come in the near future. Now, this is a nice chart to check your eye vision, especially if you sit at the back. Anyways, the goals of fundamental analysis are five. We try to predict a future value, the future price movement. Just to take a long story short, this is almost impossible, but you can understand if the prices are going higher or lower because of the previous movement. Sentiment, technical analysis, there are a lot of techniques we can use. We need to determine a fair value, and this is what fundamental analysis helps us to understand. What is the fair value? And we need to do a management evaluation. As I said before, in our case, management is the network itself. So as the network improves itself, as the network becomes better and better, then we have something with higher value. What we've seen in the past, the value that, for example, Bitcoins or all cryptocurrencies had a few months ago, has nothing to do with their future. The improvement of the network itself, the improvement of the technology itself, is what is very important in the next value of the currencies. Finally, we need to analyze the assets, and not the assets, I'm afraid, but the assets themselves. We need to understand what are cryptos and each crypto standing. As my friend Jim said before, you don't need to focus on all these no one knows crypto, new cryptocurrencies, because you're expecting that they will go up. You need to understand the underlying value for anything like it. And utility is very important. As utility, as a function of utility, we may understand the capitalization. The bigger the capitalization, the more people participate, the more the utility of this currency in the market, as well as liquidity. The more trading, the more easier to get in and out. And finally, determine the ability of this new currency to compete against its competitors. Don't forget that this new crypto space, the new crypto sea, as I like to say, has a great competitor, actually two, or now that I think three, maybe five, and all of them are the major fiat currencies. We will need to compete with US dollars, euros, yens, maybe the won, and don't forget the Swiss franc. the Swiss will not stay just looking. Now, ending my speech, we have three behavioral issues. We need ambassadors. We need people that will stand in front of other people explaining the use of these cryptocurrencies, explaining what we get back. I had a very interesting discussion a couple of hours ago about getting back our privacy in our transactions. That could be a great utility for most of us. Now, we also have negative interest rates. In 20 countries, we have negative interest rates. Now, if fiat currencies are not paying an interest rate, then they're coming closer to what the crypto space is offering to other people. And finally, confidence. And this is where we have a long way to go. Next year, or maybe year after the next, when this auditorium will be full of people, we will get a signal that the confidence level is higher. Not only the interest, the confidence level. Finally, any currency has any other currency, exactly the same, Bitcoin, has a value because people think it has value. If I get 50 euros off my pocket, the only reason that you would accept it is because you believe that another people will accept it just after you. I want to thank you very much, and I'm available for questions now or later. Thank you.